and how the game continues to evolve.
Ah, Christie, why does the bishop not show the ball in anymore? What happened to overhead putting, ground hurling, long puck dunks, psycho cornerbacks, two hands in the hurley, pull hard, he's no relative. Don't let the ambulance go until he has a full load. Like all sports, hurling changes. 25 years ago, today's why senior managers met as young lads in an All-Ireland minor final. As a near contemporary of theirs, I share their blushes at how rudimentary some of our hurling was back then. Hurling has always seen changes, and maybe some of the old hurlers sitting on the ditch have always been vexed about it. What would they have tweeted when Mackie first went on his darling solo runs? When he handed the flame to Ring in 44? When the Outlaws opened Hell's Kitchen? When revolutions came? When legends wore different colours? The heartbeat of the game has always been change and innovation. The dullest passages came when the game stagnated. Great eras have the shock of the new. Mad clearmen running up mountains until they were no longer whipping boys. Hugh Cortman looking up Patrick's Hill and inventing a running and possession game instead. Then Kilkenny redefining defence, stopping the runners with merciless ball on the shoulders, dropping players back, confident that they had some of the greatest forwards ever working down at the business end.
Keep it into the full power line, it's part of their meeting. No pressure.
25 years on, Derek McGrath and Michael O'Donoghue share another first Sunday in September, where it's not the same game they played as boys. Today's hurling is heads up. It's about short play and long, offloads and options, stick or twist, subtleties and changing up the pace. Sticks are shorter now and tight skills are more sublime. Players are thinking their way through games and doing things we've never seen before.
It's a very good shot! It's
poor coaches imitate, good coaches innovate. Thinking is good. The winner today will have had to think hard as well as play hard. The heart and the pulse have always driven the rhythm of hurling, but the imagination can lay fine airs and sweet wheels down on top of that. Hurling won't ever be a cross between the puck fodder and the strongest man at the fair competition that some people wish for. Let's not sell the game short by resisting change. For sure, in 25 years' time, McGrath and Donoghue will look at the footage of this weekend and wonder how the game has moved on. New revolutions will have rocked foot of everybody once again. That's a living game.
It's about time you stop talking with me.
He's the template, though, the yardstick. So, Christie, you don't get your wish. He said, too, that the best horrors are with us now and the best horrors are yet to come. He was right. Always will be.
Lads, I can't hear Christie spinning. Can you? But I can hear his fingers drumming impatiently. So let's shut up and let the game be the game.